It is time to mix things up a bit and go for a double header. We have a Western Star 4900 with a McNeilus Bridgemaster mixer. And joining us on the stage today is a Kenworth T880 SFFA, also with a McNeilus mixer. Both these models are made by Diecast Masters and they come in outer shipping cartons. Let's peel off the tape from the Western Star box and pull out what's inside. And out comes a box which has a colourful picture sleeve. It describes and shows a picture of the model. And it's nice that on the back of the box we have some information about the real truck and mixer. Here is the box for the Kenworth and it follows the same packaging style. And again it also has some information about the real equipment on the back. Let's open up the Western Star box and it nicely slides out. And we can see the model is held inside with a plastic former on top. Also included is a small booklet of the Diecast Masters Transport Series. And that shows there are many models to choose from. Lifting out the plastic former, there are some parts contained inside it, and we'll get those out in a moment. And then we can use the giant hand crane to carefully lift out the truck mixer. Other parts include exhaust stacks and chutes. For the assembly, we need to fit the exhaust stack extensions. And there are two on the Western Star, and one to fit on the Kenworth. The other parts to fit are the extension chutes, and there are three of them, and they clip into a holder on the side of the truck. This is a nicely modelled solution, which provides extra flexibility on the model. Out of the box and assembled, we have the Western Star 4900 and the Kenworth T880. For the detail, we'll compare the underneath of the models side by side. And the first nice point is that the mud flaps are made of soft rubber. The rear part of the chassis is the same on both models, which is not surprising as they have the mixer above. When you move towards the front of the chassis though, there are some differences between the two models. You can see that the positioning of the gearbox is different, and the chrome tanks on each side are also different. As a plus point, there are different tyre designs on the various axles. The detail of the mixer drums is excellent, including lots of tiny graphics, and the tanks and motors at the front are modelled well. The wheel arch covering the rear wheels is metal, and it has nice decoration along the edges, including tiny graphics. The wheels are plastic, but they are nicely detailed. The decoration on the Western Star version is really nice. There are excellent graphics on the drum and a nice metallic paint. And the metal drum also has the access hatch modelled. The hopper at the back is also metal. On one side there's an access platform and ladder, and these are modelled in plastic. The frame of the tag axle is modelled in metal. At the back is a folding chute and it has high quality graphics applied. And there are various lights modelled. Moving to the front, and the Western Star has high quality chrome work, and there are also nicely modelled inserts in the doors. The high quality detail includes the exhaust stacks, and there are chrome mirrors and also a grab rail. A particularly nice aspect of this model is the high quality and attractive decoration. The roof of the cab has various air horns and lights modelled, and at the front the Western Star grille looks very good. There's no number plate modelled because this is a generic model, but excellent details include the Western Star logo also on the seat backs. Moving to the Kenworth, there's less chrome work, and the model reflects the simpler lines of the real truck. The door windows have half a glass, and the body shape has pleasing details. At the front, the grille looks excellent with the Kenworth logo also on top, and the lights are high quality too. This model also has lights and air horns on the roof, and there's also a Kenworth logo on the seat backs. The features of both models are very similar, and we'll start underneath by looking at the Western Star. And there is steering at the front axle, although it's a little bit more limited than you would hope for. In contrast, the pusher axle has a very good range of steering movement. The pusher axle can also be raised up out of service when the mixer is empty. Out on the cranes, etc. superhighway, and the mixer truck rolls along very nicely. And if we test the front axle steering, we see that we get a slight curve, but not as much as you would like. In some places, the heavy load of the mixer has to be spread over more axles, and then the pusher axle gets lowered. And to spread the load even more, there's a tag axle at the back. That lowers down to produce an impressive looking truck. And as long as you push down the tag low enough, all of the axles are properly grounded. A nice touch on the side of the model is that the access ladder can be lowered. And there's also a small amount of movement possible on the hydraulic ram that controls the chute. Although it would be nice if it could be lowered a little bit further. One thing we can do is to lengthen the discharge chute. And to do that, you remove the separate sections from the holder and clip them together. Once you've got them clipped together, you can lower the chute that's fixed to the mixer and then add on the extension pieces. These parts are plastic, so they clip together easily. And then you can rotate the chute around to put the concrete wherever you want on your desktop. Of course, this is a mixer truck, so the drum spins very nice and smoothly. And moving to the front, there's another feature on the Western Star, which is the tilting hood. That works well, and there's a nice detailed engine which can be seen underneath. And it has a number of different components. The Kenworth has the same features on the McNeilus mixer. And you can also open forward the engine hood. That lets us see the engine, and there's a Packard name on it. The Kenworth also has an additional feature compared to the Western Star, and that is opening cab doors. They open to a reasonable angle and give you a bit of flexibility. So that means there are different ways you can pose the model. These are very nicely implemented truck mixer models by Diecast Masters. They've got some very nice detailing, including the use of tiny graphics. And there are also many working features, which gives you plenty of different posing opportunities. They would look great in local concrete company colours, and overall, they are excellent.